Hi, and welcome to another video for Linux.net. On Monday, the 30th of November, I did a live stream, and the following video you're going to see is an excerpt of that. I tried to tackle the Maggy pboot image, which has 17 distributions for the PinePhone, although technically six of those are Postmark address and one is jump drive. So it's just a little less, but anyway, have fun with watching the video. Unfortunately, I screwed up and forgot to turn on local recording in OBS Studio, so this is just YouTube quality from now on. I hope it's bearable. Have fun. So, waiting for a GNOME here. Oh, a cursor. That's good. Linux user. Okay, that's GNOME. And now let's try to connect this. Oh, this cable is really draining me the wall. Okay, so apparently, ugh, that looks like it's a mirrored mode. Yeah. Or maybe that dock just crept up and went to, because it sometimes does that and it just shows everything in VGA resolution, which is, yeah, not what anyone wants. That's, don't know if that's a known bug, but it's a known bug for me with the PinePhone. Can tell you that. Okay, this looks slightly better. I'm just going through this like that, and okay. Yeah, let's disconnect this. But as you can see, GNOME is really good at handling multiple screens compared to those newer mobile desktops. If you want to call them desktops, I mean, just a shell, isn't it? Okay. Next, skip. Done. Okay, let's enjoy PostmarkOS here. And, oh god, what's that? Welcome! No, I don't want to have a tour. Because I should know GNOME from using it daily. Yeah, so that doesn't work, so let me try to open the test settings up like that. And if I then turn off that screen, should be fine. But I don't see that display settings thing. It's not in, it's in devices, right? Okay. good to know. Single display mode. Okay, apparently it thinks that the screen has 40 inches. And now let's keep the changes and bam, we've got a GNOME desktop. And it's actually working quite nicely here. I mean, there's barely nothing pre-installed, but if I now run pk-u upgrade, I think it was, and type 111, can first upgrade. Postmark address here. Oh, it fetches new kernel. I doubt that that might actually ruin the image. Pboot image. If that kernel gets installed. So I'm not sure whether I should just stop that. But because this is the last thing I'm going to demo in this video, what can possibly go wrong? Is this GNOME terminal, by the way? Nope, that's KGX. So let's try to install something else. apk add gimp. Maybe LibreOffice. Don't know if that's the proper package name. The phone interface with GNOME is not good. As you could see, the apps, when I tapped here, would all go off screen. I've seen tweaks on the Mobian wiki to fix that, but I honestly tried to go through it once and fix it for me, but I couldn't really figure it out. When I had this installed on Mobian. So I'm going to install Firefox, LibreOffice and GIMP and start those, and then this video is hopefully done. Yeah, but if you want to use your PinePhone as a desktop after this session, I would say if you can tolerate GNOME, and I know there are some people that can't because it doesn't have a start menu and whatnot. I don't share these concerns personally. Then this is maybe a way to go. Otherwise, you could just build yourself a Postmark address image with XFCE, which is surely going to be fine too, maybe, but virtual input could be a problem. But yeah, you could maybe get into building yourself a custom pboot image with one distribution that has a GNOME desktop and another one that has for sure whatever you like, or maybe something lighter, XFCE, Sway, so that you've got enough RAM there, and then use the system like that. Or just put one of those regular desktops on the SD card and take that with you and use it only when you want to do some work, because actually trying to do work with Fosh, it's something that I did and it sort of works, but window management and, you know, just the convenience of tapping a key and then typing something and starting the app easily, that doesn't exist yet on Fosh. And therefore, I would always recommend, if you really are serious about, like when you're on holidays and you take your PinePhone and your convergence dock with you, and there may be a keyboard like this, and then somewhere you're at a place with a screen, then having an SD card with your files that you need and proper desktop on it could be enough for some light work. Actually quite sure it would. So Firefox apparently is installed already. So let's try that. No, let me maybe go to 0.64.org here. Oh god, Google. This privacy window there. Yeah, stupid privacy shit here. I'm just going to accept that for now. It works, then maybe open Maggie's page p-boot-demo. Yeah. So yeah, it's Firefox, it works. Of course it does work on GNOME, so let's just start top here. Maybe it's installed. Yeah, great. So that we see how we run out of RAM, and then let's try GIMP. By the way, you should know that I've got this block. And I do these weekly updates, but the more important thing in my mind right now, or has been for a while, is this apps list. It's not perfect, but you can contribute. There's even a link up here how you can do that. And please try to. That would really help a lot. So yeah, GIMP works just as it does on GNOME, just fine, I think. Yeah, we've got a canvas, and I could draw something. There's some lag, but yeah, again. Fine, just fine, I think. And LibreOffice. See how much RAM is this using? Oh my god, those aren't really user readable numbers. 300 megabytes free, I would say. Tip of the day. Did you know? Yeah. Writing a fun letter works. So yeah. I will now shut down.